So guys, let's solve now the question number 14.7 of oscillation chapter. It is from exercise question. So here we are provided with a displacement relation. There is a particle which is oscillating in simple harmonic motion or showing simple harmonic motion, and this simple harmonic motion is showing by this displacement function. So our simple harmonic motion is showing by this relation. This is a relation of displacement and equal to a cos omega t plus phi, which is generally we write the displacement or showing simple harmonic motion with displacement function by this relation. And time is 0 second, and displacement is when the particle is at 1 centimeter and its initial velocity is omega centimeter per second. If the particle is oscillating in simple harmonic motion on this path, so this the displacement of the particle is showing by the relation. When the time is 0 second, the displacement of the particle is 1 centimeter and the initial velocity is omega centimeter per second, and angular frequency is pi second inverse. हमें फाइंड आउट करना है एम्पलीट्यूड एंड इनिशियल फेज एंगल ऑफ दैट पार्टिकल. सो लेट्स यूज द रिलेशन. द रिलेशन इज एक्स टी ए कोस ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव. हियर वी आर प्रोवाइडेड विद डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज 1 सेंटीमीटर. एम्पलीट्यूड वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट. कोस omega is pi and time is 0 plus 5. Phase angle also we need to find out. So it is equal to 1 centimeter a cos phi. Now we have come with this relation. Now the next step is our velocity is omega centimeter per second. If we take derivation of it with respect to time, it will be equal to velocity and equal to minus a omega sine omega t plus phi. Velocity is equal to omega for us, it is given. Minus a omega sine omega, time is equal to 0 and angle equals to phi. So omega is cancelled with omega. We are left with 1 minus a sine 5. We are with 2 equation. This is first and this is second. So, first of scaling on scaling both of the equation and adding, we will get scaling both the equation and adding a square sine square 5 plus cos square 5, and it is equal to 1. A square equals to 2 and a equals to root 2 centimeter. So what is our amplitude? Our amplitude is root 2 centimeter. The amplitude of the particle which is oscillating in simple harmonic motion along a path, and the position is at 1 centimeter, velocity is omega, and there is path displacement is showing by this equation. We write this equation a bit upper. We are using this equation here only. So now we need to let's divide this equation first and second. It will be equal to 1 minus a sine 5 a cos 5. It will be equal to 1 equals to minus 10 phi. Take this minus here. When will be the value of 10 phi equals to minus 1? We know that the 10 45 10 pi by 4 equals to 1. So 10 pi minus pi by 4 will equals to minus 1. So it will equals to 3 pi by 4. Pi will be 3 pi by 4. Another angle we can find out by putting 2 pi here. In that case it will be 7 pi by 4. So our phase angle is 3 pi by 4 or 7 pi by 4, or our amplitude will be root 2 centimeter. Now the next question is, if you are using cos function here, if we use sine instead of cos, then what will be the consequences to changing this equation? We will find out that now. We are provided with the same detail. We just need to change the sine function instead of cos. So it will be equal to xt a sine omega t plus phi. Our displacement is 1 centimeter. Amplitude we need to find out. Sine omega time is 0. Angle frequency pi into 0 it will be equal to 0. It is pi, angle frequency 0, it will be equal to 0. So overall it is equal to phi. Now our velocity is omega. Now differentiate it with respect to time and it will be equal to velocity. It will be equal to a omega cos omega t plus phi. So velocity is omega given, omega centimeter per second, initial velocity when it is at 1 centimeter. A omega cos omega is pi, time is 0 plus phi. Omega equals to omega. Omega is cancelled with omega. So we are left with this was our first equation. We are going to use this to find out the amplitude and phase angle of the particle at that particular point. So it will be equal to 1 equal to a cos phi, and this is equation number second. Now same procedure on scaling equations first and second both sign and adding. First of all, square of 1 plus add square of second, it will be equal to a square sine square phi plus cos square phi. It is equal to 1, we everyone know. So a equals to root 2 centimeters. So by changing sine function in the place of cosine function, the amplitude of our particle will remain same. Now what is the effect on phase angle? Okay, we need to use both of the equation. Now divide as we have done it in the previous case. It will equal to 1 by 1, it will be cancelled. A sine phi upon a cos phi, amplitude get cancelled. 1 equal to 10 phi. Okay, and it happens at when phi equals to pi by 4. Okay, and another phi pi by 4. If we add pi, it will be in the third quadrant, and our 10 theta will be 10 phi will be positive, it will also give 1. So at pi by 4 or 5 pi by 4 will be our phase angle. So we are different, there is a difference between the phase angle. We are different with the phase angle instead of cos theta, otherwise our amplitude remain same. So this was our question. Thanks a lot.